Hello all, this is Muhammad Hanif from RJKT Basar. Once again, I welcome you to this session on MATLAB, and the subject we are dealing with is digital signal processing. So today we will be designing a filter using a filter designer tool in MATLAB. So while using that filter designer tool, we'll also see how we can design a low pass filter using a rectangular window in FIR method. Okay, so first we have to enable that FDA tool from our MATLAB. Okay, so there are two ways to enable that filter designer tool. One is go to this apps, and from here we have to look out for filter designer. Here you can see that signal processing communication, we do have filter designer tool, or else you can just type here as a filter, and then you can see that this is a filter designer. You can click on this so that filter designer tool will be opened in new window. And another way is we can write filter designer in command window and then enter. So it will open a filter tool for you. Okay, so this is the filter designer tool in MATLAB. So this is the filter designer tool. Here we can see that there are multiple options are given here. Out of these options, we have to go with the we have to select the particular filter or particular option you want to do, which is related to our filter designing. Okay, so here you can see that we have given with low pass, high pass, band pass, and band stop. So I am selecting low pass here, and then you can see that design method also is given here. We know that two digital methods are there for digital filters. One is IIR, another is FIR. So here, as we said earlier, that we are going to design a FIR filter. So then I am selecting FIR filter, and then using a window technique, and we'll be going with, see, in windows technique, we do have given with all these multiple options. So out of these, we'll select with the rectangular. And then here you can mention the order of the filter. Okay. And here we have to specify the frequency specifications for our filter. So I'm going with 500, and then the cutoff frequency that will give with 20 here. Okay, and then we'll design the filter. So here it will design. So this is the magnitude response for our specified specifications for filter designing. So this is low pass filter, rectangular window with sampling frequency of 500 and cutoff frequency of 20. And some other options are available. This is magnitude response, and if you click on this button, so you will get phase response for the same designed filter. Okay, and you can see, or you can observe the both the responses in single window also. So magnitude as well as phase response. Even from here we can see the poles and zeros plot for this particular design filter. So this is pole zero plot. Okay, so now after designing this filter, now we can export the coefficients of designed filter into our workspace in MATLAB here. So here you can see that there is nothing available in workspace now, but going to file and then export, by clicking on this export, we can transfer, we can export these filter coefficients from this place to our workspace. Okay, so here you can see that where you want to export it to workspace, and export as coefficients of this one. And for that coefficients, the variable name it is given as NUM. So if you want, you can change it to you can write as a capital B or any other variable name you can give. Okay, just click on export. So another way of exporting the coefficients is that directly we can generate a MATLAB code. Okay, so from here you can generate a MATLAB code. Go to file, click on MATLAB, generate MATLAB code, and then click on filter design function. So it will generate. So I'm giving LPF here. Okay, here you can see that a low pass filter code has been generated and it is written in function. Okay, so now we can utilize, we'll see how we can utilize the coefficients of filter, and then we can use in our program. Okay, so first writing sample frequency fs. So fs will, it has to be same as we have defined in our designer tool. Okay, so here we have given sampling frequency as 500 and cutoff frequency as 20. So we have to mention the same thing here. So it is 500 sampling frequency and then TS is equals to 1 upon FS, and then time period T is equal to 0 with the intervals of TS up to 1 minus TS. Now we'll generate one signal. So let's, X is equals to sine of 2 into pi into frequency as 10 and then T, and we'll add some noise to this one. To generate noise, let's, we'll write 0.2 rand n and size of T. Okay, so here what we have done, we have generated one signal with a sine function, and then we have added some random signal to that, so that the entire signal X will appear as a noise signal. Okay, so sine wave having some noise. So we'll be filtering this one using our filter coefficients here. So in next one, we'll write Y is equals to filter. So filter is a command in MATLAB which used to do filter, and where we have to mention some specifications like B comma A comma X, where B are the filter coefficients and A will go with 1, and this X is will be our input which we want to filter. Okay, so here in place of small b, we have to write the filter coefficients, which is we have given as capital B here. So B comma 1, and then so in place of X, we do have X here. So X is the this signal. And then we'll try to plot T comma X. So if you see T comma X, then we can observe the signal with having noise there. And then filter signal T comma Y. So here you can see that. Here you can see, so this is the, in blue line, this is a signal having some noise, and this one is a filtered output, so which is we can see that a sine wave. Okay, right, so this is the one way. Now we'll see another one. So one way we have seen that using the filter coefficients, another we'll try to use this function. So first let design, let enable this to LPF. Okay, so LPF is having the filter program, which we, it is a function name, so that we have assigning it to H. Okay, and then here we'll write Y2 as filter, and then we'll write H comma X. okay, and then once again we'll try to plot t comma x and then t comma y 2. So earlier you can have seen that here in y means using this filter coefficient, right? Now here as we have designed filter in y 2, so we are using y 2. Now running this program, so this is y 2. So here also you can see that. So this blue one is signal x and this orange one is having filtered output. Okay, so this is the one way by which we can generate the filter output. Okay, so here once again coming back to our filter designer tool, from here you can see that. So first we can specify the specifications of particular filter. And then later we can export that designed filter into either coefficients or we can generate a code. That code will be available in function and you have to use that function whenever you want a particular filter output. Okay, so here from this magnitude response, even you can see that the here stop band gain is also, okay, the stop band gain is about minus 20 dB. So which is normally high. So to improve this filter, what we have to do is we have to increase the order of our filter. Okay, and similarly if we know the particular window techniques, then according to the window techniques we can go with, okay, and then we can improve our filter coefficients. Okay, so I hope you have understand this. So meet you in next session. Okay. Thank you.